thing about solid that it has a definite shape and definite volume. Solids have a definite shape and a definite volume. That means they maintain, this is the meaning, all a solid maintains or keeps its shape and volume in any position or container. Wherever you put a solid, it maintains or keeps its shape and its volume. It doesn't change, okay? And the volume of solids or liquids are measured in units. For example, for solids, volume is measured or expressed in units of cubic centimeter and the cubic meter. For liquids, it's milliliter and liter. Okay, so these are the units for volume. The particles of solid are very close together. They are packed very close together. So they cannot move freely and they can only vibrate in a place. They vibrate in a place. What does it mean, vibrate in a place? They move back and forth slightly. They move back and forth in the same place. Because they are very closely together, they are packed very closely together. They don't have a freedom to move. And that's why, this is the reason that they are have a definite shape. Sorry, they have a definite shape and volume. Why solids have a definite shape and volume? Because the particles that make up a solid are packed very closely together. This fixed, closely packed arrangement of particles cause a solid to have a definite shape and volume. Is it clear till now?
Yeah.
Hello? Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Fine. So the first thing, solid. A solid, it's a type of matter that has a definite shape and volume. A definite shape and a definite volume, and it maintains it. That means it maintains or keeps its shape and volume whenever or whatever you put it in any container in any position. The particles of solid are very close to each other. They packed very close to each other. They can't move. They can't move from their places. I mean, it doesn't mean that they can't move at all. They move, but in their places, they vibrate in a place, move back and forth. This is, and look here, this figure or this image shows how the particles of a solid arranged. Look how they are very close to each other. Also, the physical properties of solid, some of them, even all solids have a definite shape and volume. It doesn't mean that all solids are the same. Some of them are hard, others are and brittle, others are soft, others are flexible, some of them are smooth, have smooth surfaces and heavy. So they have a definite properties, different properties. Okay. Yesterday we stopped here, I think, that the types of solids. You have to know that solids can be divided into two types. Those that have a crystal arrangement or their particles are arranged in a regular pattern, they are called crystalline solids. The other type is called amorphous. Okay, amorphous solid. What is the difference? Simply, in a crystalline solid, like the quartz, this one, the particles of it are arranged or have a regular pattern. Again, the particles inside quartz or quartz are aligned in a regular repeating pattern. They have a repeating pattern. They have a repeating pattern. They are arranged in a repeating pattern, in a regular repeating pattern, such as for example, cubic, some of them hexagon, they have a regular pattern. This pattern is called or creates crystal weight lathe. This is called, this regular pattern is called the crystals. This pattern creates crystals. Solids, please highlight it. Solids that are made up of crystals are called a crystalline solids. Like, for example, the quartz, many minerals. Minerals, if you remember, minerals such as table salt, sugar, all of these have a crystalline structure. If you examine or look at the, for example, at the grains of a table salt, if you look or if you use a microscope to look at the grains of table salt, you will see them in a regular pattern. This pattern is called crystals, okay? Examples of a crystalline solids, as I mentioned, salt, sugar, all of these have a crystalline structure. Most important thing.
We can melt the sugar.
Okay, طيب. Yes, they can melt. They can melt.
You mean that they have a crystallic form?
What?
You mean that they have a crystallic form?
Okay, even Sammy, even they have a crystalline structure, they melt. What's wrong, Yani? Any solid can melt. But the difference in the temperature at which the solid melt. Okay, when a crystalline solid is heated, it melts at a distinct temperature. This is the second important thing you have to know about the crystalline solids. The crystalline solids that have a crystal structure, they have a repeating pattern. Also, they melt at a distinct temperature or at a specific temperature. For example, ice melts at 0 degrees Celsius. The other type of solids, like butter, for example, this is a butter or the eraser. They don't have a crystalline structure. On the other hand, the material that makes up an eraser, for example, is amorphous. So we can divide solids. شفت الوايت وورد طلعت عندكم؟
أستاذ لا ما طلعت شو أنا مش فاهم.
Wait.
فاهم.
طلعت الوايت وورد؟
Yeah.
Okay. Types of monkeys, sorry, types of solids. Okay, the first type we call it crystalline solids. What are the properties of crystalline solids? First, they have or their particles, مالهم
heat at a distinct.
Their particles arranged in in a regular pattern. Okay, so this regular pattern is called crystals. Okay, what is the other important thing about crystalline solids? They have yalla. What? They melt.
Melt in
at a specific temperature or at a distinct temperature. Understood?
What does distinct mean?
Okay, Rajan. Distinct temperature at a certain temperature, at a specific temperature. For example, the temperature at which ice melt is different from the temperature at which iron melts. The temperature at which gold melts also are different. Crystalline solids, each material has its own melting point, or it melts at a distinct temperature, at a different temperature. Yani, you can say distinct, عشان بسرعة.
And crystalline is wrong spelling. After us, then there is no
okay.
A.
يعني distinct have many meanings, different or specific or certain. The other type of solids called what? يلا. No one can say.
Amorphous. Mr. Amorphous.
Amorphous solids. These types of materials or solids do not have. Do not have what? Do not have crystals. Or their particles. Wait. Their particles are not arranged in a regular pattern, so they do not have crystals. The amorphous solids, their particles do not or aren't arranged in a regular pattern. Also, they do not have or they do not melt at a distinct temperature.
Oh, teacher, gold and iron. أستاذ أنا مش فاهم الريجولار باتر.
Wait, استنى شوي.
Like,
again, استنى شوي. I want to talk about the amorphous solids, then we will discuss or if you have any questions. On the other hand, the material that makes up an eraser, for example, the eraser, is an amorphous solid. In amorphous solids, such as the also butter. Do you like butter? طيب. In amorphous solids,
yeah.
Such as butter shown in figure 5, for look here. This is butter. It is amorphous. Okay. In amorphous solids, such as butter, the particles, this is very important, مالهم particles are not arranged in a regular pattern. They do not have crystal. They do not have crystals. Their particles
that's
are
why butter is not touching
the knife. Did you take in math the shapes? Did you take in math the shapes?
Yeah.
Okay. The crystalline solids, their particles make a shape. Huh? To understand it, the crystalline solids, their particles are arranged in a repeating pattern or they form a shape. Like, for example, some of them arranged in a cubic pattern, some of them a hexagon. These arrangement or this regular arrangement of particles are called crystals, and that's why they are called crystalline solids. On the other hand, the amorphous solids, their particles are not arranged in a regular pattern. They don't make a shape. You can say that their particles are arranged in a random way. Okay. Another property of amorphous solid that they does not melt at a distinct temperature. For example, glass is an example of an amorphous solid. So glass, butter, eraser, for example, the material that is the eraser, all of these are amorphous solids. The glass might look crystalline when it is cut into nice shapes, but it is amorphous because of its particle arrangement and the fact that it does not melt at a specific temperature. A glass blower can bend and shape glass that has been heated because it gradually becomes softer. So glass melts gradually, doesn't melt like crystalline solids at a specific temperature. A glass blower, for example, can bend and shape glass that has been heated because it gradually becomes softer. Rubber also amorphous. Rubber and plastics are other examples of amorphous solids. They are very useful in manufacturing because they can be gradually heated and cooled to take specific detailed shapes such as shoes, soles, and toys. So, in this page, I can summarize this page. This page is page 50. This is a summary. طيب. types of solids.
Mister, لو سمحت يعني.
Wait.
ما تحكي.
Wait. Types of solids. Crystalline solids and amorphous. Okay. The difference between them that the crystalline solids, their particles arranged in a regular pattern. This regular pattern is called the crystals. Examples of crystalline solids: table salt, minerals such as quartz, sugar. All of these are crystalline solids. Their particles make a shape, a regular shape, or a crystals. Also, they melt at a distinct temperature, at a specific temperature. For example, for water, for ice, ice melts at 0 degrees Celsius. I don't memorize or I don't remember the melting point of iron, but it's very high. So each crystalline
2048.
Solid,
wait. 2048.
The other type of, sorry. The other type of whiteboard فتحت عندكم؟
زمان.
الهس فاتحة قصدي؟ الوايتبورد؟
اه فاتحة.
Okay. The other type of solids is called A. It's called what? The amorphous solids. They, how are they different from crystalline solids? That their particles are not arranged in a crystal shape, or they are not arranged in a regular pattern. And also, the amorphous solids do not melt at a specific temperature or at a distinct temperature. Examples of amorphous solids, rubber, plastics, glass, butter, all of these are examples of amorphous solids. We have comments or questions. Elaine, what's wrong? Elaine.
أستاذ مش فاهم. مش فاهم الريجولار باترن.
طيب.
شو الريجولار باترن؟
Did you take shapes in math?
Yeah.
طيب. Regular pattern. Okay.
أستاذ الكوارتز عنده مليون جهة يعني مش ريجولار.
هذا if you look at it in the microscope you will see that they make a pattern like rectangular for example like cubic. شباب الباقي مش فاهمين انتوا كمان؟
انا فاهم مستر بس في سؤال.
شباب والله ولا واحد يعمل ميوت ولا واحد يعمل ميوت الان الكل يطلع الصوت لو سمحتوا شغلوا المايكس. طيب راشد ادم تيم ريان لين الياس do you understand
yes
طيب مش مشكلة بنعيدها كمان مرة ان شاء الله مرة
طيب الريجولار صورة للريجولار باترن
طيب wait a minute wait a minute please wait okay wait
wait
مين طلع من الدردشة طيب خلص مش مشكلة بجيب لك صورة للريجولار باترن طيب طلعت انت صورة الكتاب
لا
مستر
يا
اوكي ليتس دو ذا اكسبيرمنت ريدنج تشيك
طب مستر بس خليني اسالك السؤال
ايش؟
مستر هسه احنا نصح ال اسمه بارتيكلز بيعملوا شيب بيعملوا باتن
يس
فمستر يعني مثلا بيعملوا كيوب مثلا اذا في عندنا باتر زي اللي بالكتاب بيعملوا مثلا الكيوب ولا بيعملوا ايش؟
لا سامي بليز ويت يو هاف تو لوك ات ذا باتر يو كان كات ات ان ا ريجولار شيب باتر بات if you look at its particles in the actual in the microscope or they are not regular. It doesn't mean, for example, you can make a regular pattern with rubber, with plastics, you not you, but I mean their particles. And you can't judge by your eyes. You need tools. Look at the particles, for example. When you here, as you see, it is being, it is makes
better.
But butter is amorphous because their particles are not arranged in a regular pattern. Look at this. A fat of butter is an amorphous solid. The particles that make up the butter are not arranged in a regular pattern. Okay? Now, look at this question. In your own words, explain the main difference between crystalline solids and amorphous solids. Who can answer? Raise your hand.
Mr.
Raj, okay.
First of all, butter is way easier to cut and melt down. But crystal, it's a little, it's like almost impossible to break it, and it's really hard to melt it down.
Start from the beginning again.
First of all, butter, it's
the question is not about butter.
So,
Rashid, about amorphous solids, what is the difference between amorphous and crystalline and amorphous? Not only butter, yani, you must talk in general.
Rashid, can I?
Yeah, Rashid, okay. Continue, Rashid.
So, amorphous solids are soft and like they're easy to cut down. And for example, butter and...
Good, but Rashid, it's not always true. That it doesn't mean that all amorphous solids must be soft. No. So glass.
No. For example, soft. It could be ice. Ice is not soft, but its pattern is not right.
Excellent. The first thing that amorphous solids do not have a regular pattern. Continue.
But on the other hand, crystalline solids have a good pattern. They have a repeated pattern.
Regular pattern.
Or regular pattern.
Yes, that's right. Thank you. Ty, what is the other difference? Can anyone add? Can anyone add another difference? Thank you, Rashid. Ahmed Sharaf, Ashraf.
It will be melted in a specific temperature.
And Ahmed, ليش الصوت عندك مش واضح؟ So I will send you the answer by the way. The amorphous solids also, the amorphous solids do not melt at a specific temperature or at a distinct temperature, while crystalline solids melt at a certain or a distinct temperature. Let's talk about now, let's go to the liquids. The second state of matter is liquid. We want today to talk about liquids. Of course, liquids are different from solids. A liquid has a definite volume, but no shape of its own. Or you can say that a liquid has a definite volume, but no shape of its own. For example, if you have 100 or 1 liter of water. If you bring 1 liter of water and put it in a container, if you put it in another container, its volume will not change. It will stay 1 liter, but it will change its shape according to the shape of the new container. For example, if you put water in this cup, it will take the shape of this cup. If you put it in another cup with a different shape, it will take the shape of the new cup. But the volume stays the same. Is it clear? Look here, please.
Yeah.
طلع. This is water. What is the volume of water here? 150 milliliters.
Milliliters.
On the ground, it will stay 150 milliliters, but its shape will change. Here, for example, it is a spherical shape. But here, it takes the shape of the ground.
Because the liquid does not have a different shape.
Yes, you can say that. Thank you, Sammy. That solids or a solid has a definite shape, volume, sorry, but its shape is not definite. It doesn't have, it doesn't maintain. A liquid cannot maintain its shape. Okay, so what happens when you spill a drink? It spreads into a wide, shallow puddle as shown. Okay, without a container, your drink does not have a definite shape. Like a solid, however, it does have a constant volume. So solids, sorry, liquids always have a constant volume, but their shape change according to the to its container. According to its container, is it clear?
Yeah.
What about the particles of liquids? Of course, the arrangement of particles in liquids are not the same as the particles in a solid. In general, the particles in a liquid are always in contact with another They are always in contact with one another. They are packed almost as closely together as those in solid. So the particles in liquid somehow are close together as those in solid. However, the particles in a liquid are not fixed in a place. Okay, so if you we want to describe the particles of liquid, we say that they are packed together or almost close together as those in a solid, but they are not fixed in a place. That means they can move, around. While the particles in a solid, they can't move around. They just vibrate in place. شباب, فهمين?
Vibrate in place, لأنا ما فهمتهاش في آخر إشي.
مكانه يا ليلى. يعني أنت ال particles of solid بتحرك بس بمكانه. ما بروح.
بس بمكانه.
طيب. But the particles in a liquid can move around one another.
Okay.
Can move around one another. Okay, طيب. You can compare this movement to the way you might move a group of marbles. Okay, تعرف marbles?
Yes.
You can compare.
The واحد.
You can compare the movement of particles in a liquid to the movement of a group of marbles around you in your hand. Like the particles of a liquid, the marbles slide around one another. This is another important thing. The particles in a liquid slide around one another, but still what? Touch. They don't remember that they are always in contact with one another. They are always in contact with one another. طيب. These really moving particles allow a liquid to flow from place to place. So one important property of liquids that they can flow from place to another to place, and that's why rivers can flow. Okay, why rivers can move from place to place? Because the particles of a liquid can flow. So for this reason, a liquid is called a fluid. So a liquid is called a fluid, meaning a substance that flows. Liquids can flow. What does mean flow? Move from place to place. Why they can flow? Because the particles can slide around one another. Okay, طيب. I want to end the meeting because there is no time. Do you have any comments?
No.
Bye.
So they didn't understand the float.
الباب الكل مش فاهم ولا بس لاي؟
بس لاي.
We will repeat on Sunday, inshallah. On Monday.
أستاذ مش فاهم فلويد أنا.
Wait. خلاص.